Hi, my name is PK Gulati. I'm the founder of The Assembly. If you're here, you're probably watching an Assembly workshop. We do these workshops every week, and these are prepared by the Assembly team in Dubai. These workshops cover ideas from data sciences, hardware design, automation, robotics, drones, and all the other exponential technologies that you can think about. The idea is for us to learn more than what curriculum teaches us. And we are trying to bring people to start working with their own hands with these technologies which have the capacity of changing the world. So welcome to this workshop and learn more about new wonders, what you can build.
Hello guys, welcome back to another workshop. In today's workshop, we'll see how we can control a snake game using gesture control. We'll be using Python language, which involves libraries like OpenCV, MediaPipe, and PyGame. So before we proceed with the workshop, let me introduce the Assembly. Assembly is a smart lab based out of Infi since December 2014. Since then, we have completed over 300 free workshops. The three main types of workshops we mainly focus on are Hack, Code, and Data Science. Hack deals with embedded systems, IoT, hardware, etc. Code deals with software projects, APIs, frameworks, and apps. Data Science, as the name suggests, deals with topics related to artificial intelligence and machine learning. Our target audience are students, working professionals, entrepreneurs, basically anyone who's interested in the field of technology. We focus mainly on smart technology and its applications. We also have a forum where we discuss about the recent advances in the field of technology. Do follow us on our social media pages, YouTube, Facebook, Twitter, and Insta for more upcoming workshops. So let's get back to our workshop now. So we'll be making a snake game that can be controlled using gestures. So as a marker, we'll be using a colored object at the tip of your finger or a pointer. So we'll be using OpenCV library in our project. So OpenCV is basically used for computer vision applications. It is widely used to improve machine perception skills. So to install OpenCV for Python, we can run the code pip install OpenCV-Python. Next, we'll be using PyGame. So PyGame is used for creating fully featured games and other multimedia programs in Python language. So to install PyGame, we can run the code pip install PyGame. Lastly, we'll be using the MediaPipe library. So MediaPipe is a framework for building different machine learning models. Some of the best machine learning models created using MediaPipe are face detection models, object detection and tracking, and multi-hand tracking models. So to install MediaPipe, we can run the code pip install MediaPipe. So let's start coding now. So firstly, we'll import all the required libraries. So first we'll do import CV2, which is OpenCV. Then we'll import PyGame. Next we'll import MediaPipe as MP. Next we'll import random. Random we'll be using later in the code for randomizing the values of the foot position. So next we'll initialize the PyGame window. So for that we'll do pygame.init. We'll set the colors which we'll be using in our project. So we'll be using red, green, blue, and a hybrid color. So for that we'll set red is equal to 255,000. Then green is equal to 0,255,000. Then blue equal to 0,0,255. Then for the hybrid color, we'll do hybrid is equal to 23,234,223. So this is the colors which we'll be using in our project. Next, we'll make this the window for the playing the game. So for the snake window is equal to pygame dot display dot set, and open the brackets. 600,600 is the width of the window, so we'll set it as that. Next, we'll give the name for the window, which is snake game. So pygame dot display dot set caption, open brackets, we'll type snake window, snake game. In PyGame, we have to update each and every step after showing something. So we'll do PyGame like after, if you have to show like the snake game or like the score of the game, or we have to update after each and every step. So pygame dot display dot update. So that's it. Next, we'll set a clock function, clock variable. So clock is equal to pygame dot time dot clock. We'll be using this variable later in the code. We'll set the font for the score. So for that, we'll do score font is equal to pygame dot font. We'll be using the system font, so it'll be sys font none, no color, so we'll keep it as none, and we'll set 30. Next, we'll be having three functions. We'll be having the write score function. We'll be having the create body function and the game loop function. So we'll set three functions. So def def write score. So text def. We'll have the write score function. So def write score text comma color comma, we'll have the x and y positions, x comma y. Next, we'll have the create body function. We'll create all the functions first. So def create body. So in that, we have this, it's done in the snake window. So we have the snake window here. So that's that. And then it's the game loop. So game loop. So these are the three functions we'll be having in the project. So next, we'll finish the write score function now first. So firstly, here we'll have the screen text. So screen text score font dot render. We'll have the text here. Then we'll type true command, then the color. So then we'll have snake window blit screen. So screen, we'll call the screen text here. So screen text comma x comma y. So that's the write score function. Next, we'll go. We'll finish the create body function. So here's create create body function. So for that, we'll be having a for loop. So for x comma y in snake list pygame dot draw dot rectangle snake window comma color comma x comma y the positions comma snake size and snake size again comma snake size. So that's the create body function. So next we'll move on to the game loop function. So for that, we'll have two variables. First, we'll have game exit and game over. So game exit is equal to false and game true, no, game x game over is equal to false. We'll keep both as false. Next, we'll have the snake head positions. So snake head x is equal to 100. Then snake head y is equal to 100. We'll also set the score to 0 in the starting. So score is equal to 0. Next, we'll set the foot positions. So for that, we'll have foot x is equal to, we'll be using the random model here. So random dot random 2,19 to have the these foot rectangles inside the window. So 2,19 into 30. Similarly, for the foot y is equal to random dot random 2,19 star 30. So that's for the foot. Next, we'll set the speed. This is for the pointer. So for the speed, pointer location, okay, speed x is equal to 0 and speed y is equal to 0. Next, we'll have the we'll set the snake size to 30, and we'll have a snake we'll have a list, snake list. This no open square brackets and close. We'll also have the snake length, the increment. So is equal to 1. FPS we'll set to 60 to have a smooth gameplay. So FPS equal to 60. And now we'll bring in the camera. For that we'll do cam is equal to cb2.videoCapture in brackets we'll add 0. Next we'll be using the MediaPy library to get the hands. So mp hand is equal to mp.solution. We are getting the hand function in the MediaPy from MediaPy. So that mp.solutions.hands. So then mp hands is equal to mp hand dot hands. We're getting the hands function from the MediaPy library. So now we'll do the we'll draw those trace lines. For that we'll do mp draw is equal to mp solution mp dot solutions dot drawing utils. Okay, so these are the functions we'll be calling. Next we'll have a while loop to check. So while not game exit. So if this condition, then we'll have an if loop here. So if game over equal to true, we'll now if the game is over, we'll fill the window with red color and we'll display the score here. So we'll do a snake window dot fill red. Next we'll be having we'll be writing the score. For writing score we'll call the write score function. So for that write score is equal to, so write score game over press space to play game again, and we'll display the score also. So your score is equal to, so we'll call this we'll bring the score to display it here. So str score, then so we want the text in green color, so we'll do comma green comma 10 comma 100. This is the position and the size. We'll update the screen again. So for that pygame dot display dot update, that's that. Next we'll check for the events if occurs. So for event in pygame dot event dot get, so we'll get all the events which occur in the game, the game. So for that, if the user wants to quit, so if event dot type is equal to pygame, sorry, is equal to pygame dot quit, then we'll have game exit is equal to true. So game exit is equal to true. Else if we are having the if loop again, not the else loop. So if event type event dot type is equal to pygame dot k space. So this is like if the user press the space button, we'll have to restart the game again. So for that pygame dot key dot, sorry, if event dot key is equal to pygame dot k space, we'll run the game loop again. So now if the user doesn't want to quit the game or the game is not getting over, so we'll have the else condition now. So else, so it'll be success, we'll get the image readings. So for that success comma img is equal to cam.read, we'll get the readings from the camera. Then we'll resize the image to 600 comma 600 to the window size. So image is equal to cv2.resize img comma brackets open 600 comma 600. Next we'll have the output is equal to mp hands dot process image. We'll have the if condition now. We'll to check the landmark hand landmarks. So for that if output dot multi and landmarks. Then we'll have a for loop here. So for landmarks, we are checking the landmarks and like how many, if there are multiple landmarks or not. For that, we're checking this statement now. So for landmarks, so then so each of these landmarks will have its own ID and its positions. So for that, for ID comma position in enumerate landmarks dot landmark. Okay, so the pictures will be having its own height, width and the z coordinate. So for that we'll have height comma width comma z. Since there is no depth, so we keep it as z only. This is equal to image dot shape. Then we get the position, so pos x comma pos y is equal to int width star pos dot x comma int height star bracket open pos dot y. So next we'll check if id is equal to 8. So if this is true, then we'll draw the circles in the marker window. So cv2 dot circle comma cv2 dot filled. So we'll fill the circle with blue color. Next cv2 dot circle image comma 300 comma 300 comma red. Again we are filling the circle with red color here. Cv2 dot filled. So then we'll do cv2 dot circle. This is for the pointer. Cv2 dot circle image comma pos x comma pos y comma 25 comma the hybrid color. We'll be using the hybrid in this place, so we're filling the circle with the hybrid color cv2 dot filled. Then we'll check the positions now. So if position x greater than 350 and position y less than 350 and position y greater than 250. So if this statement is true, then we'll be having speed. So we'll be moving this is a direction, so we'll be moving towards the right or left. So speed x is equal to minus 3 and we'll have speed y is equal to 0. So we'll copy the same sentence around 4 times for all the 4 directions. So copy. So then we'll change the settings. If for the second one will be greater than 250 first, greater than 250, and the second parts remain same, and here it will be plus 3 here, so it will be going towards the positive side. Next here it will be POS Y, it's the same setup, and here it will be POS X less than 350 and POS X greater than 250. If this is true, we'll again have a speed Y here, and here we hang speed x here. So we'll have speed y is equal to minus 3 and speed x will be 0. Similarly, if here position y greater than 350 and position x less than 350 and position x less than 250. So if this condition is true, we'll have speed y set to plus 3 and speed x set to 0. So this is the direction part. Next we'll check for any events in this thing. So for event in pygame dot event dot get. So if this condition, we'll check for the for loop. I will bring it on here. So okay, so it's correct. The intonation is the main part in Python programming. So if one intonation goes wrong, the full code will not run. So we'll check if event dot type is equal to, we are again checking if the player wants to quit or not. So pygame dot quit. So if he wants to quit, then we'll do game exit is equal to true. Otherwise, we'll come out of the for loop now. If the snakehead, we'll get the absolute position to get the food. Now we'll add the code to like how the snake eats the food. For that part, we're adding the code now for that, so that we'll get the absolute position for the ABS is equal to snake head x foot x less than 30 and absolute position of snake. Now we'll do the y coordinates of snake head at y less than 50, sorry, not less than 50, snake head y hyphen foot y. So we'll check if this is less than 30 now. So if this is less than 30, then we'll have we'll set the random position of foot. So foot x is equal to random dot random 2,19 star 30 for the y foot y is equal to random dot random 2,19 star 30. So we multiply it by 30 times. Now if this condition is true, we'll add the score by 5 points so that score is plus equal to 5. We'll increase the snake length also. We'll add the snake length here. So if 5 points get increased, and if the snake gets to the foot, the snake length increase also increases. So snake length plus equal to 5. So now we'll get out of the loop. So we'll do snake. We'll add speed x to the snake length. Snake head. So snake head x is equal to plus equal to speed x. So snake head y plus equal to speed y. Now after this we'll add the we'll add color to the window so that snake window dot fill blue. Okay, now we'll write the score on the window. For that, write score equal to, we'll call the score here. So for that we'll do plus str score comma red, we'll have the thing in red color, the score in red color, 10,10. Next, we'll have a body. Body is equal to close open brackets. Then we'll append it to the body. So body dot append snake. We'll append the snake head position to the to body. So snake head x body dot append snake head y. So then we'll append the body to the snake list. So for that we'll do snake list dot append body. So next we'll check if the snake's head is going outside the window size. So if it's going, the game gets over that second. So if snake head x less than 0 or snake head x greater than 600, which is the window size, or snake head y less than 50 or snake head y greater than 600. So if this condition is true, the game gets over. Game over is equal to true. Next, we'll check the snake length if snake length less than of the snake, if the snake length is less than what's there in the list, we'll delete the list in this snake list. We'll delete the first element in the snake list. So for that, we'll do if snake length less than length of snake list, we'll delete the snake, the first element. So delete snake list, first element. So next, if body in snake list minus one. So if this condition is also true, the game gets over. Game over is equal to true. So yeah, that's the main part. Now we'll create the body. So for that, create dot body, we'll have it in the snake window. So snake window, we'll have it in red color. So red comma snake list comma snake size. Then we'll draw the rectangles for the foot, for the snake, and for the point, the marker. So for that, pygame dot draw dot rect snake window comma hybrid comma 0, 0. The 600 is the window size comma 50. This is true. Then we'll have the pygame again, pygame dot draw dot rectangle snake window comma green. This is the for the foot. So we have the foot will be in green color. So green comma foot x comma foot y comma snake. So we'll have the foot also as same of the snake size, which is one box. So snake size comma snake size for x and y. Okay, so snake size, same we'll have it for the snake also. So we'll copy the code again, copy the full code, copy, just forgot to put the closing bracket. Okay, so copy the code, paste it here. Now here, instead of snake, instead of foot, we'll have the snake head. Then snake size and snake size remain same, and we'll change the color from green to red. Then we'll update again the display. So pygame dot display dot update. Now to show these windows, we'll do cv2 dot im show snake game comma image. So these two windows will be shown now. So next we'll have the wait key. So cv2 dot wait key 1, and we have the clock here to have a smooth transition of the snake movement. Otherwise, if you don't add this clock statement, the snake will come and go like it in a second. So to avoid that, we're adding the clock statement. So clock dot tick fps. Then we'll run the game loop again. So game. So that's the end of our code. Now we'll we'll check for any errors and output. So now let's check the output. So we'll run the code, so F5. So okay, we can see that we have an error here. So we'll delete this, not required here, and it's snake list, not size. So list. Yep, and okay, so there's one more error here. It's scream here, so it should be screen. So that also done. So the should remove the square bracket. as you guys can see that we have a small error here. It's again typing error. So it should be multi, but I wrote MULI. So in line number 54. So here it's multi hand. So MULTI and run FI. Okay, I have one more error. It should be okay, body.append. So in line number 88. Body.append. Here you go. We have one more small error. It's create underscore body, not create dot body. So in line number 97, we are having like here. So create underscore body. So now after clearing all the errors, now let's check the output. So we'll bring it down now. So you can see it comes down now. Go more to the right, move your hand to the right, come down again. Move to the left. You want to go left. See, so as you guys can see, we can play a snake game using gestures. If you go outside the screen, the game stops and it displays your score. So that's it for today, guys. Thank you for watching today's workshop. Do like, share and subscribe to our channel for more such workshops and activities. Also, do follow us on our social media channels and stay connected for our upcoming workshops.